go over for our advanced training how to get into our pike position when we're in the air. Because it is challenging to learn the pivot points and understand that the hips are a wheel that we're rotating. Most people try to bring their legs towards the sky like an L shape, and then they don't have any leverage to roll over. So we're going to do this from our sumo squat with our leg loops supporting us so we feel safe to roll forward and back. Most people, they're going to flip all the way over if they don't learn the pivot point as well. So if you do flip over with the leg loops on, it's totally safe. Okay, so leg loops are nice and high on the top of our hips, on the top of our legs. I'm going to hold on to the nub, the part of the webbing where it meets the fabric of the leg loop, just one side. And I'm going to start to kick up. So this is usually as far as people go. So they're just going to bring their legs up to about an L shape. And that's as far as they're like, oh, I'm stuck, you can't do it. That's usually what people do. So what we want to do is learn how to engage our arms, lean back, and tuck our head towards our knees so that our hips can come up. So I stay rolled up in a little ball, and then I can roll forward and back really easy with almost no effort. I'm just using the momentum, and my hips are going to point up towards the sky. That's the key. Most people get about here, and they stay stuck. So I'm going to roll all the way back. My head tucked in. If I don't tuck in, that's when I fall over. So if I stay tucked in, I won't fall over. If you fall over, I can usually flip back around. But otherwise, if you come all the way over and you get stuck, so just say, you didn't stay tucked in, you're like this. So then, of course, the momentum is going to bring you over. You just come to stand and try again. Okay? So if you can't flip back over, it's okay. So you might get a little twisted, but don't worry about it too much. I want you to just practice using your core with our training wheels and then practice coming all the way over. Notice my feet are over my head and my head is towards my knees, and I can roll forward and back with ease. Let's see how this translates into our high flyer. So we're going to release the leg loops, wrap the legs around, come on up. Remember to use the core to come up, okay? So in these high flyer positions, I like to use the hand holds. So not the leg loops, the hand holds. So this is not the pose. Everyone does that when they come forward. It is a push-up position with the elbows towards the sky, and then, like you're extending from a tricep curl, you can come forward. So this is a forward flip. We have to keep legs together, push the hips forward, and come on up in that same wheel position. Same with a backflip. Legs together, roll all the way over, and you can come into birdcage. So we're going to go forward and back a few times. Pull, push the hips, straight legs. I roll up. Elbows towards the sky, lean forward. Forward flip. Keep going for an infinite number of turns. Same with the backflips. I can keep going. All right, so after we do our bird cage, then why don't we go ahead and just do one more Jedi kick to come out. So I'm going to hold on to one hand hold and go a little faster this time. Swim. All right, nice and fun. So just practice the pivot points there more than trying to get the tricks, so that you're not efforting it as much as really finding the alignment.